Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So yeah, today's video is going to be a no makeup makeup look. And before I start blabbing some crap out of my mouth, let's get into the video, because if I start a thing, I can talk anything. And I'm starting talking. But I wanted to say something. No, I don't want to say it. Let's get into the video and I will teach you how to do no makeup makeup look quick and easy. Maybe not quick and easy, but yeah, let's do it. So before starting, I want to clear this myth or misconception people have that no makeup makeup is no makeup. In fact, no makeup makeup is a lot of makeup, but placing it very wisely so that it looks like you're not wearing a lot of makeup. So I posted a video sometime recently on Instagram. So somebody said that, you know, no makeup makeup, maybe itna makeup. So yeah, there is a lot of makeup involved, but your job is to make it look like as natural as possible. If you have really good skin, then it is really easy, you know, to get that really natural no makeup makeup look. It's gonna look really pretty. But if you have some, like, you know, major scars or major pigmentation around the eyes and the mouth, you might want to compromise into like a more natural finish. It is going to look really less and minimal, but because you have all that discoloration, you kind of have to add a little more product to cover it up and make it even, so you kind of have to compromise on it looking natural. So I used to have a lot of scars, I do have a lot of scars even now, but I used to have really bad scars, more brighter, darker scars, like back 3-5 months ago. So now it's faded away, so it's a little easier for me to, you know, cover these up. But back then, you know, it was really difficult. I had to use something full coverage to cover the scars. So if you're like, you know, suffer with this, I completely understand. So you can go with something which is more full coverage. You can use or whatever I'm using, but maybe just use a bit more coverage products, you know, according to your skin. So first we'll just go in with a concealer. I'm using this concealer from LA Girl. This is in the shade Almond. It is kind of my skin, but a tad bit darker. It has a little orange tones, a little hint of orange. So it's really good to, you know, correct anything and neutralize everything before, you know, I go in with something a little brightening or something which matches my exact skin tone. If I'm looking up, because I changed the position of my laptop to screen mirror, you know, the phone, so it's a little up, so I'm just looking like this and I'm like, you can do this as foundation also, completely fine. I'll, you know, there's one video on my Instagram. I'll just, you know, put a photo here. If you want, you can go click on my Instagram, check it. And since, you know, I'm trying to make this look compatible for everybody, I'm going in with concealer. But if you want, you can completely use a foundation. Just go around with foundation, 3 dots around the eye, and you know, wherever you require a little, and it's completely enough. It's done. You don't need a lot of it. So I'm just going in with the concealer. So you can see, like, it has a hint of orange. It's a tad bit darker than my skin. That's it. And it has like slight hint of orange in there. I'm going in with this concealer wherever I have, like, you know, a little bit of discoloration. So that is around the eye and around my mouth. Now the spots on the cheek can get covered with my regular concealer, like the shade which matches me perfectly. But I'm just using this too. You can do that or completely avoid it. So I'm just gonna let it sit like for 30 seconds to 1 minute. I guess for this I'll just do 30 seconds because this concealer does dry down really quickly. So I'll just let it sit for 30 seconds and then I'll start blending my concealer so that, you know, the coverage doesn't disappear. So 30 seconds is done. I'm just taking this normal, it's kind of like an eyeshadow brush, but I really like it to blend my concealer. It just gives a very, very thin application and looks really, really natural. So I'm just using this brush from La Cara. This is E6, soft brush to blend that concealer. Just blends it very, very well, you know, applying a thin layer. Can, like, you know, completely see the difference already. Everything kind of looks really brightened up, corrected, and quite even compared to, you know, this side. really nice concealer as well, with medium to full coverage, so a light layer of it is just going to balance everything out and look really nice.
Here in this video, I just used a concealer which is a little warm and has a little orange tint, because I wanted to show how you can use it for all the skin types. If you have like deeply pigmented scars or discoloration, if I have to do it, like personally, I just go in with a concealer which matches my exact skin tone, because that is enough for me, because I don't have like a lot of discoloration. So if you have like really even skin and you don't have extreme discoloration, then you can definitely just go in with a concealer which matches your skin.
Now, for the step I did, if you did apply the exact concealer which matches your skin, you are done right here. You don't have to apply more. You can use a concealer now. You can use a very sheer coverage foundation. You can use a BB cream. You can use a tinted moisturizer. Anything. It's just because now you kind of evened out all the discoloration you have on your face. The layer you're going to apply on top of this is just going to look really, what do you say, natural look. That's the only word I know right now. I'm just going in with this Sugar Power Clay BB Cushion. It's a very, very sheer to medium type of product. Gives a very beautiful finish. It looks very, very natural on the skin. So I really like how it looks. So I'm just going to, lightly dab that on my face. My eye as well. I conceal my eyes really, really well, the top lid, the bottom lid, because I love the way my face looks. It looks really awake. My features kind of pop a lot, so when I do that, I always, natural look, whatever look, I do conceal my eyes a lot. So you can, kind of not do that if you don't like, or you can just avoid applying on the top lid. You can actually have that brown kind of shadow going on, but I do always do that. I don't know, it's like a habit. I really like how it looks. So this just, evened out your entire skin, and your, whole entire face looks of the same color and looks very even. You don't see any discoloration, you don't see any blemishes. Kind of what you want for a no makeup makeup, your skin but better type of look. Next, just take any powder. I love using a translucent powder because it's really thin. It doesn't really create any cake or any layer on your face, but so I really like it. I'm just going to lightly dab this powder all over my face so that everything looks pretty mattified and set under the eyes. So everybody has to set, because you don't want concealer or anything to crease. So we're not going to do a lot of eyeshadow, so might as well set that lid, because we won't have that eyeshadow color to help it not crease. I just have two spots right here which didn't get covered, so I'm just going in with that brush and lightly dabbing the product on that area to just conceal that particular part. You can see everything looks pretty matte and nice. Everything's kind of covered. You can see my discoloration and scars coming through a little bit, but it's like a hint. It's everything is blurred away. So that's kind of what you want to achieve with a no makeup makeup look. So everything looks pretty matte and soft. It's a thin layer of stuff. There's nothing really heavy or cakey. Next, I'm just going in with bronzer. This is the KKW Beauty Contour 6. I'm going to apply this precisely first to contour my face. So I'm just going to apply it right here. Now you can see there's a shadow there. After that, I'm just going to blend it upwards and melt it into my skin. I don't want that harsh line, but I want that definition there. I want everything to look really blended. Now you can see it's very, very soft, but there is still dimension there. So just apply concentrate product and start blending upwards. Don't blend it downwards, so again, you can make your face look very droopy and saggy, which is never the goal. So I'm just going around the jaw as well, just to add a little more definition. This is again a Lakara F002 brush, and the sponge I used is Plumco. This is their Celestial sponge. So for the nose, you can precisely contour if you want, but I just like to bronze up my entire nose. It looks really nice, and I kind of get that warmth back to the nose. Now you can completely stop here. or you can go in with a blush. I am going to go in with the blush because blush adds so much life to your face. And for a no makeup makeup look where everything is like kind of cancelled out, you want that flush of color which looks really nice. But you have to really be careful when you go in with blush. You don't want to go overboard because it can end up looking a little clowny. So you need to be very mindful how much you apply to get that natural finish, or else again it's going to look a little, you know, heavy. If you have cream blush, completely fine, you can add it. Cream blush gives the most beautiful soft effect. But if you don't have a cream blush, you can completely use a powder blush. I can't talk, it's like a powder blush. Or you, if you have some lipstick and you really like the shade, you know, for it to use as a blush, you can do that. Just make sure lipstick dry down really quickly, so just add one dot, kind of, you know, blend it out, then add the other dot and blend it out so that you don't add, you know, end up having two patches. But I have a cream blush. This is the Ruby Organics in the shade Orchid. I really love this blush. So I'm just going to add a tiny bit, really tiny bit. I probably should have done this before, like powdering my face, but this blush, you know, doesn't lift off anything. It does work really well on top of powder as well, so you know, I kind of can do this. But if you want to go in with cream blush, then you know, do it before you go in with powder. I'm just going to take a slight, very tiny bit. You know, I kind of go overboard sometimes because I do like blush a lot. So yeah, I kind of like how it looks, but if you still think it's a little strong, you can go around with your sponge again and kind of tone it down or blend it until, you know, it kind of tones down. Cream blushes are a blessing and they look really pretty. So if you go in with cream blush before powder, you can kind of set it and, you know, it's going to stay in place. But because I already use powder, I'm just going to take a slight amount and lightly, just I just took a tiny amount and just dabbing it on the blush. Looks really nice. I love how this looks. Looks so pretty. For next highlighter according to me is not so important. You can surely go in with one if you want, but yeah, if you want, then just go on the high points of the cheek, maybe a tiny bit to just capture light when light hits you. But you can avoid it if you want, you know, to get a really natural finish, because nobody has a glitter on their face, you know, which shines like natural, right? So next, now what we can do is for eyes, I'm just going to take in the same bronzer I used before and I'm just going to add that in the crease. Just going to, you know, warm up the eyelid as well and bring everything together. I'm going to get that until the nose and join it with the nose, so all around the crease and joining it with the nose. Going to add dimension. It's a very soft color. You can see, like, you can't see on camera because if I have to, you know, if it has to be seen on camera, I have to add a lot of it, because but I don't, you know, want to add a lot of it because I want to look, make it look really soft. So if you can see it, then fine, or else it's like it's how it's supposed to be. It's very soft. And I do really enjoy applying a full liner type of thing, so I do take the same bronzer and kind of just like to create that four liner type of look. So yeah, you know, it kind of creates that fake cat eye. It's very soft, it's that subtle, you cannot see it. Just going to play with your eyes and, you know, while it catches light. On the lower lash line, just going to add the definition back to the eyes. You're going to go in with brows. So like, you guys already know, I don't do a lot with my brows, especially if it's a no makeup makeup look. I kind of keep it as it is. I don't even carve it. Like, you can already see I completed my eyes and everything. So I just go in with a little bit. I have a little gap here and little gap here, so I'm just going to fill that in and that's it. I'm not going to do much. I'm going to keep them as natural as possible. So if you have really thin brows, then just go in with a little bit of product and stroke the hair. Don't like draw block brows, you know, it's never going to look natural. Just, you know, I'm just going to fill it in and comb. That's it. You see, that only kind of made I like, you know, my brows really thick and big already. So I need to be really careful with my brows. I cannot overdo them or else they're going to just overpower my entire face. No matter which look I'm doing, I always have to highlight my inner corner. I just cannot not do it because it pops my features, my eyes really, really well, and I do enjoy doing them. Until and unless I highlight my inner corner, I don't feel like, you know, I've completed the look and I look good enough. So I'm just going to add that on the inner corner. I'm sweating so badly. So don't just, you know, make it stay harsh. You can kind of blend it in and make it look like you have a lighter shadow right there. Doesn't have to be really harsh. Just, you know, create a shadow there, which is light. It's just that tiny amount you can add and blend it in. It's going to look soft, but you're going to have that shadow right there, which will grab light. A little on the eyebrow bone. I'm just adding this now that because I started it. You don't have to do this. If you want to add the highlighter, then you can add right here. I added a lot of it, but you know, it's kind of blended with your hand. It's going to look really soft. So don't apply a highlighter on the nose. Not really necessary. You kind of bronzed it up. It's going to look really natural. Now we just have two steps left to go. That is mascara. Actually, it's lip. Mascara, setting spray, and lipstick. So I don't really have to show how you know how to apply mascara. So I'm just going to skip that step and I'll complete everything and I'll be right back. I just see my skin, but better. I don't see really heavy product anywhere. So yeah guys, that is the finished look. I just added this Lakme Absolute lipstick in Morning Coffee on my lips. It's a very soft, new type of look. Really looks really pretty. Yeah, so my makeup might not be looking as good as it normally does, like with that full glam, with that contour, highlight, really, really strong, you know, colors and everything, vibrant, because you know, we tried to do a no makeup makeup look, which, so it's kind of going to look really natural and not so good on camera, because makeup on camera is quite different compared to makeup in real life. Let me know in the comments if you like this look and you want to see more. I can't talk at this point because, you know, I don't have anybody around me to talk a lot, so I kind of forgot how to talk. I just talk to my phone now these days. So yeah, anyways, if you like this look, then make sure you like, share, subscribe, and ring the notification bell. It'll mean the world to me. And if you do, you know, create this look or try any tips from this look, then do tag me. I would love to see it. And yeah, that's it for today's video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye. We'll be right back.